Assassin's Creed is now becoming like Fortnite. Bloodborne is coming to PC, and arenas in Apex Legends are now coming to ranked. Hey, what is up everybody? Welcome back once again to Gamer Crate. Make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to watch more videos just like this. And you are watching right now top gaming news of this very week. So let's just jump right into that one. Looks like it's going to be the end of Assassin's Creed after a new report came from Bloomberg. According to this report, Assassin's Creed Infinity, which is the code name for the next Assassin's Creed game, will be a live service game. This game is going to expand and develop after launch, similar to how games like Fortnite or even GTA Online have been bringing with new seasons and new content every time to change the world of these games. Looks like Assassin's Creed will be adopting that one. It looks like both Ubisoft Montreal and Ubisoft Quebec will be working on this one as a joint project, with Ubisoft Quebec taking the charge. Along with that, these two studios apparently have some kind of a rivalry against each other, and now they'll be working together. So that's gonna be very good. With this report, Ubisoft themselves made it official that this game is in early stages of development and are looking to change the way these games are made. This news is of course not liked by many people who were already disappointed by how Assassin's Creed was going towards since the release of Odyssey and Valhalla, even though both these games were very good. Now fans, including myself, are much more worried to see where Assassin's Creed is heading into. I mean, it has gone to live service, which is not what Assassin's Creed is supposed to be. Although from a business point of view, I think I understand why they're doing this. However, this is not how Assassin's Creed was developed. Of course, the golden time of Assassin's Creed was still Assassin's Creed Black Flag, in my opinion, where the game was set in various places around history, tying up with the stories that happened in that time and including assassins into it. Now, Jason Schreier from Bloomberg says that there will be a solo narrative stuff for the game, although it will be part of Infinity. He even says that they can just focus on this one game and keep it evolving instead of making another game every single year, which will be completely different from head to toe, which again takes a long time. Well, it's too early to say what and how this game is going to be shaped as, but it is very, very concerning to see where Assassin's Creed is going towards. And a lot of fans are so disappointed that they don't want to play the next Assassin's Creed game. And I kind of don't blame them. For people like us who enjoy story games and single player games, I think a live service is not the best thing, because I don't enjoy a lot of live service games out there. I do play some multiplayer here and there, but live service game just turns down the amount of love you can give to a single player experience. Witcher 3, which is known to be the most successful RPG game of all time, made by CD Projekt Red. And then there's Cyberpunk. Witcher 3 had its last DLC, The Blood and the Wine, which came out almost 5 years ago, and even though the game has been around for 6 long years, there's more content on the way. There will be a next-gen update for the game coming to PS5, Xbox Series S and X, as well as on PC, along with a brand new DLC content based on the Netflix show. This was officially announced on Twitter, talking about how this new DLC will be based on Netflix show and will be free, although more info will be coming sometime soon. Well, maybe this DLC will not be extra content. It could be possible that this DLC will bring in some new weapons, maybe new outfits, maybe new look, or something like that. It won't be an expansion of a story. That's what I feel like, because Witcher is 6 years old now, and I don't think so they will have a new content. But then again, you can never count CD Projekt Red out, because you all know what Cyberpunk happened. Whatever happened with that game, you know how it failed, and I believe so that CD Projekt Red wants to work on more content for Witcher and provide it to the next gen consoles, and that includes PC as well. Regardless, it's going to be a free DLC, and if anybody has not played the game yet, including me, which I promised to myself that I'll play that game this very year for sure, 100%, I have promised that to somebody else as well. I think it's a great chance for everybody to witness and understand why this game was one of the best and why everybody wanted to believe that Cyberpunk would be great too. A lot of people also complain about how the combat system for the game is, you know, swinging the sword for so many times, but you won't be able to dodge because your swinging animation is not over yet. That is something that is kind of irritating in my opinion, but I don't know if that will be fixed in this new version of the game. We don't know, but it's going to be called Complete Edition. We shall wait and see what they will be bringing somewhat soon this very year, I believe. Speaking of Witcher, the next season of Witcher will be dropping on December 17th on Netflix, and you can watch the trailer by clicking on the link in the description below. After a large amount of rumors coming from left, right and center about the various PlayStation exclusive game coming to PC, here's another one for you. Don't worry, even I am very much sick of these rumors which never comes true. Now this rumor is coming from 4chan, where many of the rumors previously do sometimes come true and sometimes not, so take this rumor with a pinch of salt. One of the users mentioned that Bloodborne Endless Nocturne is to be released on September this year for PlayStation 5 as well as for PC. It will be a PS4 port and will be handled by a small team of From Software and will target 8K resolution and uncapped FPS, while PS5 will get a 4K 60fps game. It has also been mentioned that it's gonna be just a port with minor texture upgrades. As I said before, this is a rumor, so you should take this with a pinch of salt, meaning that you should not take this seriously. Now there's some things that does not fit well. According to this rumor, it will be uncapped FPS with 8K resolution, but there won't be many texture upgrades. There will be minor texture reworks or upgrades, which feel odd because if you want to make a game to be made for the next gen console, you would definitely be changing the texture, changing the lighting and changing the way it looks so that it can, you know, utilize whatever the new gen technology is being used in PlayStation 5 and even with PC and with the RTX graphics card. If that's not the case, then I believe that this rumor is kind of faulty in that area. Again, there's been loads and loads of rumors since 2019 that Bloodborne is coming to PC. There was a leak of an image on Steam which turned out to be fake. But again, we don't know what is true and what is not because the world of internet, that's not a good place to venture on. We already saw a PlayStation State of Play, but that only showcased some of the indie games and no major games there. And there's another rumor. Here we go again. There's another rumor that another PlayStation State of Play will be happening by the end of this month. So maybe at that time is when we will see something like the major games, the major big titles, and maybe Bloodborne will be in them. And to be honest, that next State of Play has to happen this year because PlayStation only talking about indie games and not about their major studios does not fit. So definitely that's happening sometime in the coming months or weeks. You never know. We will have to wait and see. But what do you guys think about Bloodborne? Do you think that it should come to PC? And how many of you guys are waiting for that game to come to PC? Let me know in the comments below. One game that kept on adding more and more stuff is Apex Legends. Recently, they revealed another event coming tomorrow called Thrill Seekers event with a brand new 3v3 map for Apex Arenas, which if you didn't know, is literally booming right now. A hell lot more players are playing Arenas instead of Battle Royale, which is interesting. Arenas is basically a small section of the map where it will be a 3v3 scenario with a CSGO style fight, but every round you earn a bit of currency to then buy some more guns or grenades and then try to win that round. Your teammates die, well, they're not returning and you are on your own. Each round will have 3 matches and the team who wins 2 rounds wins the game. With the huge success of this mode, it looks like Arenas are heading towards ranked now. In the recent EA Play's Future FPS panel, game director Chad Greener confirmed that in Season 10, ranked play will be coming for Arenas. Nothing was mentioned on how the ranked will be working for Arenas, but it might be similar to how it's done right now, matching up with similar level players with badge and charm rewards for everybody. But since those rules are more opted for Battle Royale, maybe they're changing the rules for Arenas. Just like Valorant and Overwatch have their placement matches, maybe you will also have these placement matches and then you go along definitely like Valorant style or maybe Overwatch style. Well, we will have to wait and see what this arena ranked will be like because apparently the next season is coming out next month and it's only a few weeks. So let's wait it out and see what this new ranked will be for people who will be playing Arenas. What do you guys think about arenas in general in Apex Legends? Do you think that's a much fun mode than Battle Royale itself? Let me know in the comments below because I did play a little bit of arenas and it is fun. I'll say that. I'll give it to Apex Legends or sorry, Respawn. I'll give it to Respawn. They've done a good job. Your hatred for a map might be so high that you probably just want to stop playing that game. That's exactly what Ubisoft is doing with Rainbow Six Siege now. But you cannot stop playing that game, can you? Rainbow Six Siege's most disliked map, Favela, is now heading towards ranked in the next update. The map got a recent update in the North Star update of the game and it was supposed to be a casual rework. But now devs are so much confident that they want to introduce that map to ranked because they believe it is balanced enough. The map is now available in ranked and unranked playlists on test servers and will be coming to live servers in the Y6S 2.2 update that's coming later this month. The rework of the map has a new layout which addresses the common gripes while maintaining the visual identity of the map. The most drastic change can be noticed by the exterior of the map, where there are fewer destructible walls. Previously, with overwhelming amount of destructible walls that you needed to reinforce, made the bomb site quite frustrating to defend. While on the attacking side, there would be a lot of spawn peak kills happening all the time, and quite frankly, it was very hard to deal with those attackers because they will be always spawn peeking and getting all the kills. Now the rework allows plenty of room to breathe while defending, with less spawn peaks and more staircases for easier navigation. This map, as everybody knows, is a nighttime only map, so that makes it a bit harder and interesting with this new rework. It looks like a lot of people are happy with it in general, and with that feedback is why Ubisoft is bringing it to ranked. Of course, you can try that new map out. It's available right now on test servers and will be available in the online servers pretty soon, in like a few weeks, maybe 1 or 2 weeks. So if you want to wait and try that out, then you can do that as well. Thank you everybody for watching this episode of Top Gaming News. Hope you guys got some information out of it. And if you did, leave a like, comment down below what you think about any of the news we just discussed in this very episode. And do not forget to subscribe to Gamer Connect to watch more videos about games and so much more every single week. My name is Gin Manus, and I shall see you guys in the next one. Until then, stay awesome, stay safe, and make sure to have fun with whatever games that you play every single day or week or month or whenever.